Byzantium. 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 Okay. That's the name of it. It might be something else, but I spelled it for you. I'm going to tell you about that. I recently saw that. I thought it was going to be like a TV series or something, but it was just a movie. And I watched the whole entire movie without falling asleep. So I thought, okay, yeah, since y'all requested me tell y'all about the last movie I saw, I'm going to tell you. I seen a couple of things. I seen Uber, but that, I think there was more like a series. Yeah, I've been watching Billions. That's a series. I've been watching The Time Traveler Wife, which is a movie, and I think it's a series now. she bumped into him. But what happened was she went into the front of the club, and I guess she started working at the bar. And as she was working at the bar, when he came up and asked one of the girls, did they see them? See this girl named Clara? And everybody was like, no, no, no. But then when he got to Clara, he looked at her, even though she looked modern today, she looked like the old, old picture. And I'm like, dang, that's her. That's Clara. So when she saw him, she took off. She started running. She was running through hallways, through buildings. She was trying to get away from this man. She ran real good. She was trying to make it home, trying to get away from him, right? And then it went back to Eleanor. While Eleanor was throwing the pages out the window, and basically in some of these pages, it was saying like how she eat. She feeds off of, you know, humans to stay alive. And I guess that was in the pages. And when she looked down at the window, she saw an old man walking. He was frail. He was walking. And one of the pages fell by his foot. So he went and he picked it up. And he unraveled the page. And then he looked up at her. And he saw her. And she looked down at him. And it's like, I was like, oh no, what's about to happen? Because he was not supposed to see her. But he saw her. So next thing you know, she came downstairs from, you know, her apartment, and she sat on the porch, and she saw the man, and the man came, and he sat down where she was at, and they began to talk, and he told her that, you know, everybody got secrets and stuff like that, and he asked her, well, she could talk to him and tell her, you know, his secret. And she's like, are you sure? He's like, yeah, I've been around for a long time. I was taking it as in, yeah, he got time. You're an old man. He ain't working. He frail. He ain't got nothing to do. He could listen to her story. That's where I took it. So next thing you know, she walked him up to his apartment. She helped him get snugged in, I guess, sit down or whatever, and begin to tell him her story, right? So I thought she was about to tell him what she wrote down, but instead, she had this long one fingernail. Her and Clara both had one long fingernail. It was all long, and it looked a little thick to me. I thought it should be like a little thinner, but it was like a long pink, like natural nail, right? And he took it, and she stuck it in his wrist, and it's just said, shh. And then she began to feed off of him, and I was like, well, dang, she didn't even tell him the story, I guess, when he said that he'd been around already long enough. I guess he was letting her know, like, I know your secret, I know you gotta feed, go ahead and feed off of me. And I was like, oh my god, that was just like, whoa, she just sucked him dry. And then after she finished sucking him dry, I guess while she was beating up him, Clara ran home, and she got into their apartment, and the guy came in their apartment after her, and he caught her, basically letting her know, like, you know, whatever. He, I don't know what he was going to do with her at the beginning. I found out later, and she was still trying to get away from him, and she told him she had to use the bathroom or something. He let her go. Then she came back. She grabbed some type of tool. It was some weird tool. And then, next thing you know, she grabbed him, went behind him, grabbed him by the neck, put this tool behind his neck, and she stretched it. And it clean took his head off. And I was just like, I thought he was like a regular human, just like a cop or something. After her, maybe she committed crimes or something. And for some reason, I was saying to myself, she had to do all that. She just took the man's head off. Oh my God, she took it clean off. The strength, girl. I can't even. The strength. Oh my God. And then, Clara, I guess, apartment, and she was like, Peg, get your Miss, no, Clara came, no. Eleanor came in the apartment and Clara told her, come on, come on, come on. We got to pack. We got to get out of here. We got to go. And Eleanor was just like, oh my God, why? Like, she was confused like me. Why did you kill the man? She was like, look, we got to get out of here. We got to go. We got to pass the wheels to go. So her and I guess Eleanor packed their bag and they left. They went to a new place, new town or something like that. And when they got there, Eleanor was like, it looked familiar. It looked like we've been here before. I remember this place. And she's like, okay. Claire was like, okay, I'll be back. I gotta go make us some money. So basically, she was a professional. See if she could make some money, which she did. She started, I guess, her thing, her prostituting and whatever. And Eleanor landed in this place. I'm not surprised. Now I'm thinking about it. She went to an old folks home. And I did realize that it just seemed like it was always Eleanor around old people. You know what I mean? She's 16. She always around old people. So she went to and she saw a banana piano. I don't know why she walked in there and just sat down and started playing the piano. And she started playing like old, old music that wasn't from our time. Like not even from like 100 years ago. Maybe like way back. So a young man noticed that she was playing that old music and he was intrigued. So he went to her and, you know, asked her, how did she learn to play like that? And she told him just by, I think, watching or memory or practice or something like that. So then he told her that for some reason he lied to her. He was attracted to her. So he was like, I get off at 10, you know. And she was like, okay, so what? Like, she didn't care if he was getting off or whatever. What time he was getting off, she got out of there. She left. But she didn't go nowhere. She kind of hung out outside the place, sat down, like, just chilling out. But you know, I didn't think about it now, but she was just like she was just waiting. I feel like the old people was praying and she was just waiting for a good time to eat, to feed. I guess that what it was. But I looked at her, she looked so pretty and so like young. I guess I didn't think about that until now, because now I know about the movie. I'm thinking about the scenes that I'm telling you about. Like when she told the guy she didn't want his number, why didn't she just go? Why was she outside when he got off of work? Because she must have been sitting around waiting or something, I guess. And when he got off of work, he sat down next to her. He started talking to her. I think he gave her some money. And I don't know. He was just like, he was concerned for her. Looking at her as if she, maybe he knew she had nowhere to go. Now, while she, Eleanor is talking to this young man, Claire is out off. She's been prostituting all day. Claire been off prostituting all day. But then this gentleman came in. He handed her the money. He was not your most handsome man. I don't think he was like the type of man that most, like, you know, he wasn't all that. You know, not really attractive. Sad, he handed her the money. So Claire immediately bent down to her knees and started to unzip him. He was like, no, no, I don't want this. I just want somebody to do. My mother died. And Claire was like, oh, okay. She's like, oh, your mom died. She said, oh, I'm so sorry. So she backed off of him. And they sat down and they talked. He was like, telling her that he had to bury his mother or whatever the case may be. And then Claire was like, because she was inside of a, like, a carnival booth, like, you know, when you play games and there's little bears and teddies and swishes around and you throw something, maybe a bottle or a She's in one of those carts prostituting y'all. I don't know if she broke any or what, but she was in here. And she was like, oh, that's so sad. Your mom died. Do you want to go back to your house and do this? We could pick up at your house. It was like, well, it's really my mom's house. She said, but it's okay. It's okay. I'll get you through this. He was like, oh, okay. So he took her. They started proceeding to go back home to his house, right? But she went looking for her sister, Eleanor. And Eleanor was just walking when she left the boy. And she was like, Eleanor, Eleanor. Yay, for Pete. Like, she was just so happy. She found basically a fool, okay? I don't know what else to call him. He ain't really no fool. He was vulnerable. He lost his mom, and she was a beautiful woman, not somebody that probably would choose him. They kind of lost his marbles for a second, so he taking her back to the house. So she was like, Eleanor, Eleanor, we got somewhere to go. He's so nice. And she introduced, said, this is my sister. So Eleanor looking at him like... And so they get to the mom's house. It turns out to be an old, like non-kept, non-maintenance, scary looking hotel. That's where the mom lived. It was like, whoa, like wow. So then I remember Eleanor singing that, you know, where she was at looked familiar. So Claire probably knew that she can go there, because if she wasn't there for like 100 years, who's gonna remember her face? You know what I mean? So she could go back there. So then they got on the elevator, had the elevator with them little fences, and then you go upstairs, and they went upstairs on a high floor, and she was like, okay, we could get back to our business, but first you gotta show Eleanor her room. So he was like, okay. He took Eleanor to her room, to her where this is gonna be her room. And then she kind of was standing there, kind of frozen, still, and scared. And he was like, to his hand on her shoulder, kind of like trying to like comfort her, and told her, your sister told me everything about you, and told me, you know, how you lived in an awful place. You don't have to worry about being scared here. Nobody's ever gonna do anything to you here. And so, she turned around and she told the man, she's not my sister. And that's when Claire was like, looking at her like, and she told the man, she's always misbehaving and lying and stuff like that. And she kind of like manipulated the man to not listen to Eleanor, and they went in the room, proceeded to basically have sex. And Eleanor went, you know, I guess looking around in her room and everything. Then she started writing and going back into the journal, and she went back and she started talking about basically Claire. And a quick story about Claire. Claire was a young girl, maybe about, I would say between 12 or 13, maybe less than that. She was on the beach and looked like she was working. Two military men came up. I say militant. Back in the day, they were on the horses. Cars weren't out yet, y'all. I don't even know if the horses and buggies was out yet. But anyway, they was on horses. And one of the men got off the horse and gave the young girl a pearl. And she looked at it and she put it in her pocket. I was like, oh, that's nice. The militant man gave her a pearl. The second militant man came over to her, looked at her, and said something to her. And I don't know if he told her she was pretty or what, but she was like, he told her he was going to take her somewhere and told her to get on the horse. And then the militant man that gave her the pearl was like, no, she too young. She just a girl. I was like, yeah, she just a baby. What he about to do with her? And then next thing you know, he took Claire to a prostitute house and took her in the house and basically did what he wanted with her. And then as he was fixing his clothes and she laying on the bed as a little girl, you know, all distraught, hurting and everything, he was leaving. And he said, now you got your profession. And she was like, she said to him, all you did was take. And he was like, he called all kinds of names, like whole words and everything. And so, and then threw money at her and told her he'll be back. And then told the other lady, I guess she should be, had enough practice by time he get back from being, you know, prostitute out. And I was like, oh my God, dang, that was terrible. Like, whoa, you know. And then, let's see. And then Claire, they showed that she was pregnant. She got pregnant by this militant man after she had the baby. She took the baby to an orphanage, like, but it grew up with nuns and everything. And then she continued working as a prostitute. Like, they said in the movie, she was to continue being on her knees and her back to make money, to make sure Eleanor was being raised properly. So she prostituted to take care of Eleanor, but she never went around Eleanor. Eleanor didn't know that she was her mother at the time. So that was the story that Claire started talking about, right? And Claire started getting to know the young gentleman. And as she was getting to know him, he was kind of like falling for her, wanting to get to know her more. And she kept rejecting him. And then one day he invited her to his party. And it, I guess, I don't know what kind of party, I can't remember if it was a birthday party or not. But she went, and he basically told her that his mother thinks that she's his girlfriend or whatever. And he looked like they started to fall in love because they kissed and all this stuff. And he was telling her he wanted to know who she is. He wanted to know the truth about her. And they was in some type of same school or something. So she decided to write who she was, and she gave it to him. She gave it to him and told him the truth. And then when he saw her, one day she showed back up, I think at his job, and he said to her, how old are you? And she said, 200 years old. I was thinking like 2000, but she said 200 years old. And he was like, and she said, yeah, I'll be 16 years old forever now. You know my truth. And then I think she thought that from there they would fall in love and stuff like that. But he was reading it. It was just that the more he read it, everything that Eleanor, everything she ever did in her life and what Clea did was in the book. So then he took it and gave it to like a teacher or a principal. And once he gave it to that, everybody knew that she was basically, why was she right that she killed people, she a vampire, she sucked blood, all this stuff. So then they started checking her out and everything like that. And they called Claire to the school and let them know that all the stuff that Eleanor said and things just, like she's something not right about her and stuff like that. So Claire was just telling them that she was making up tales, that none of it's true or whatever. And I think that Claire was going to kill the principal that was basically informing about Eleanor. But something had happened. I can't remember right now. Two guys showed up looking for Claire. And these two guys was tracing her. And one of the two guys was the militant man from years ago who gave her the pearl. And he was tracing her. But when they caught her, I guess when they was talking to her or whatever, the guy was telling her she wasn't supposed to be a vampire because Claire was not supposed to be a vampire. But what happened was the second military guy that made her a prostitute, years later, the man with the pearl had died, and they went to this island, like they was looking for treasure or whatever, and he was sick, it was a dying man. They went inside the mountains, everybody looking for treasure. When he went inside the mountain, something killed him, and it was was like, he saw himself two times, and the guy that was with him saw him dead, so he took off his ring, he took his wallet, everything, and then he went back to the prostitute house, and he was telling Claire, as she an older woman now, telling her that who the guy was, that the guy was, he took her, he took his life. Everything he had belonged to a dead guy, and that's why he had what he had. But one night, the dead guy showed up to Claire, and Claire took him to the guy after, I guess they had sex, and everything, he knocked out, and the windows closed, and he told him, he said, open up the windows, all the blinders, whatever. So Claire does it, and the man is just sleeping, drunk and everything, and she opened up, and she's like this, or, you know, I like the dark. Closed the windows, but when he looked up, the dead guy that he remembered that died on that island was standing. He was like, I saw you, you was dead. Da, 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 da. So the guy was like telling him he was dead, but then he was healed. And basically, he came back to offer the guy the same token, wanting him to be a vampire because in the movie, the vampire was like a brotherhood, only men could be. So he left the box on the table and told the guy he'd go to this island and do what he gotta do. He'll become, live internally. Well, while he was sleeping drunk, Claire took his gun and as he was leaving, shot him and then took the box and ran. And she ran to the island, to the treasure. She followed the map and everything, got to the island, got inside, and then she became a vampire years later. That's why the vampire men were tracing her and everything, because she actually stole eternal life. It's supposed to be given to you, but she stole it, and it was only supposed to be given to men, not women, and Claire took it, and she became a vampire, like I said. So then, years later, now she living with her daughter, calling her daughter her sister, because they look like the same age. Claire looked like she about 22, 23, and the girl looked like a young girl, 16, like she said. So she, instead of telling people she's her mother, she says sister, because she too, the girl's too old to be her daughter, you know what I mean, and the looks and everything. So after Claire got caught, going back to Eleanor had a meeting with the principal again. The principal was telling her that she needs to stop making up these stories and that they're going to help her and stuff like that. And Eleanor told her, the lady told her, prove it to me that this story is true, because Eleanor Kazan is true. She's a vampire. She's been, well, not a vampire, but she's been living for over 200 years, and everything she wrote down was true. The lady said, prove it. She said, I can't prove it, but I can prove it over time. And the lady said, what? She said, over time, when you old and in your wheelchair and can't really take your last breath, I'll be there and you'll be looking at me as nothing never moved or changed, and time never went nowhere. And that's when, and from there, it just got crazy. It was a really, really good movie. They ended up running and fighting for their lives, and the two vampire men that was hunting Claire down found her, and they was about to chop off her head, but then she started yelling out, but she's like, you the man with the pearl, you the man with the pearl that gave me the pearl. So he remembered the little girl who she was that had the pearl, and then instead of chopping off her head, he chopped off the man head that was with him. So I guess it's gonna be like a number two. I think it's gonna be a number two, because the young girl went and gave the same box. She took the box and gave it to the young boy because she found out he was dying of cancer. And I guess she was about to feed off of him because he was dying anyway. But instead of doing that, she gave him